So thanks so much for the presentation, and today I present some results of our European project alternative. In particular, we are working on the development of a cardiac tissue, bioengineered cardiac tissue, for the testing of chemical mixtures made by drugs and environmental pollution, chemical pollution. So I will start. So the chemical cardiotoxicity in particular, we are exposed continuously to different chemicals during our life, and these chemicals can be collected by different type of absorption, like other compounds, other food, consumer products, the air we breathe. In particular, we observe that there are many, for example, pharmaceuticals in the environment that can be absorbed by different routes and different way from food, from the water, from different compounds. And these compounds, this drug can interact with other chemicals, for example, the particulate, the chemical of a product by different industries, by cosmetics, by toys. So our idea is to analyze cardiotoxicity in particular, also cover the most present cardiovascular disease, and in particular of this disease, 25% is due to the environmental pollution. So it's important to understand how, for example, environmental factors and lifestyle can interact and obtain some effect on the cardiac tissue. In particular, this is marked also in the age population. In our project in particular, we try to mimic in some way, we want to mimic the cardiac age tissue. So, in particular also we saw that several chemicals has been reported to exhibit a cardiac toxic effect. In this case, we have limited regulation experience. In fact, in the rich regulation, we see that there is irritation test, genotoxicity test, but it's totally absent the cardiovascular effect of chemicals. And we try with this project to fill this little gap in the supporting the regulation. We see that cardiotoxicity chemical is part of general subchronic toxicity studies, and impact is not fully understood. In our project, we want to develop, as I said in the introduction, a bioengineered 3D scaffold, 3D system, to mimic the human heart cellular organization. In particular, in our case, we want to, as first step, we will integrate GELMA, made with 3D GELMA, with a co-culture of cardiomyocytes derived from pluripotent stem cells and endothelial cells that are supporting cells, in our case, as is important part also of the heart system. From the material point of view, the GELMA synthesis is not a commercial product, but is made by Politecnico Turin, that is also the coordinator of the project. As you can see, the synthesis starts from gelatin type A that react with metacrylyl anhydride to obtain the gelatin metacrylyl. And this hydrogel formulation is solubilized in an aqueous media. In particular, we normally use also the cell culture media just to remove every kind of different potential problems for the cells, together with the photoinitiator. The chemical crosslink happens through light irradiation with at 365 nanometers for 50 seconds, more or less, and 10 milliwatt for centimeter square. The use of GELMA is useful because we can tune the stiffness of the material, so we can modulate also we can create the both a young and aged cardiac tissue in this way, from a mechanical point of view. The GELMA was made with two different degrees of metacylation, the GELMA low and the GELMA high. So the GELMA low is correspond to 40% of the metacylation, and the high to 95% of the metacylation, as can be observed also from magnetic resonance analysis. You can see there is a different shift of the curve present in the different two concentration. And also we performed was characterized from a mechanical point of view. As you can see, there is the different, we perform different tests with different concentration of the gelma with different, with two different degree of metacrylation. So the storage modulus is quite stable before the illumination. Then we start with the UV radiation and with the continuous increase and become stable once again when we turn off the radiation. And also we observe an increase of the storage modulus after the photocuring that is quite significant with an increase very high for the 10% respect to the 5% of concentration of the gelma. We move to the part of cells, sorry. So we start for pluripotent stem cells. We start we arrive to a 50-60% of confluence of our cells. Then we start to the differentiation, and as you can see, we change the media with medium A, medium B, that are specific media for our differentiation of the cells. Cells start to change the shape from a very packed configuration to a round configuration to a very different and much more elongated configuration. And then we maintain for at least 12 days in the maintenance media, where at the end of the this day, we can observe, I don't know if it start. Okay, probably should start. It's beating, but not so much. Okay, no. So, as you can see, they are beating at the end of the process. We start to characterize cells to see if there are really cardiomyocytes. So we tested with the immunofluorescence. We tested cardiotroponin and actinin A. And in the normal form of pluripotent cells, the troponin is totally absent, while in the differentiated cells, we observe the presence of cardiotroponin as also of actinin A. And we also characterize from a real-time point of view, observing that there is a total increase of the relative expression of the troponin 2. Then we move to the co-culture with the endothelial cells. We perform different tests, in particular on cell viability, and we test also different ratio of endothelial and cardiomyocytes. So we start from 100 cardiomyocytes that are our gold standard, and we test different, two different concentrations, 10% of endothelial cells and 20% of endothelial cells in two different type of media, because the media is, we had to think about that there are endothelial cells that could be much more sensitive to the change of media. So we started with cell viability, and there are no specific modification cell viability. But when we analyzed some specific gene of the cells, we can observe that there is, for example, in particular for connexin 43, there is a huge increase of the connexin in 80% cardiomyocytes, in 20% of endothelial cells in endothelial media. And also for brain maturative peptide, that is another marker, another cardiac marker that we want to observe, and they support us in the effective maturation of cardiac cells. We move to the 3D environment also. So we seed cells in germa. Also in this case, we observe the viability in the different ratio, but in particular we observe the modulation of specific gene markers. We, for example, we tested the cardiac progenitor markers. So this is a marker that should be much less present when cardiomyocytes start to maturate. We observe also the metabolic marker, the glucose metabolic marker ALDO-A is another marker that, in fact, in cardiomyocytes, when start to be mature, they start to lose the glucose pathway and start much more focused on the fatty acid pathway marker. And finally, we observe also some cardiac maturation marker, like also CX43, BMP, that are much more present in the co-culture respect to the single culture. This is just also here a short video where we observe the contraction of the cells in the environments. I don't know if it's, as you can see, this is the 2D environment. It doesn't start, so obviously. Okay, no, it started, but it's quite clear. And as you can see, in 3D environment, there is also here the contraction of the cells in the gelma that is quite quantifiable also. Finally, we started to test the cardiotoxicity effect of doxorubicin, that is a gold standard in cardiotoxicity studies, to observe which is the trend of evaluation of different markers on cells. So we, after differentiation protocol, we mixed together endothelial cells and cardiomyocytes. We left for 1 week in the gelma solution. And then we started to administrate doxorubicin for 1 week. At the end of the experiment, we tested different assay of about cell viability, about oxidative stress, about specific cardiac cell marker, endothelial cell marker, apoptosis, and then a part of the samples were sent to the omics analysis, because in our project we have to perform a global picture in terms of multi-omics analysis, in terms of transcriptomics, metabolomics, and proteomics to see which are the potential markers associated with cardiotoxicity. And these are the results. As you can see from cell viability, for example, there is a decrease of an increase in terms of viability of cells in 3D environment respect to the 2D environment, in particular with an increase of concentration. At the same time, we observe a significant increase of release of LDH in 2D environment respect to the 3D environment. At the same time, there is less oxidative stress in 3D respect to the 2D environment. Also in terms of, for example, release of the troponin, that is a cardiac cell marker that is released during the damaging of the membrane of the cells, that is much less released in the 3D environment. We tested also the P53, that is a cell marker of apoptosis, but provides strange at the moment results, so we have to test different markers, and also we perform just only in 3D because there is no endothelial cells in the 2D environment. We test also endothelial 1, that is a cell endothelial cell marker, specific endothelial cell marker, and we observe also a decrease of its release, because it's continually released by cells, so a decrease of release on highest concentration in the 3D environment. We perform also EC50, and can be observed that there is a continuous, there is an increase of the EC50 in the different markers at the 3D environment. So consider that our cells, our system, it's quite as present in literature, that the 3D environment support better and support and increase the resistance of cells to the chemicals. To conclude, the gelma supports cell life and replicated the 3D environment. The increase of gelma concentration can simulate different physiopathological condition. In particular, in our work, we want to simulate better the old, the aged cardiac tissue. The integration endothelial cells support the maturation of cardiomyocytes, and the 3D model, as I said before, present high resistance to the chemical with respect to the standard culture. So it's important also for the evaluation of the and translation of these results to the in vivo situation. And the alternative cardiac model can mimic, in our opinion, the in vivo situation in terms of co-culture and the geometry. It could be better replicate the physiological response of the drugs. In the next phase of the work, we will integrate also scaffold. We will a 3D printed scaffold. We will culture our system in a sensorized bioreactor. Where are present electrical electrodes for electrical stimulation to further improve the maturation of cardiomyocytes, in present also a flow, so to mimic as much as possible the real condition that support the cell life. I want to thank the teams, in particular my teams from National Research Council with Antonio Cecchettini, Elisa, Ilaria Gisone, Manuela, Letizia e Silvia, and the Polytechnic on Turin led by Gianluca Ciardelli and other groups. As I said before, this is a European project, so this is our mandatory disclaimer, and please follow us on our alternative social network and website. So thanks a lot for your time.
Thanks, Federico. Okay. It was a great talk. The floor is now open for questions. Okay, then I'm going to start with a question.
Yep.
So in one of your early slides, you showed the storage modulus increasing post-curing.
Yeah.
I found it rather strange that after curing you have an increase in the modulus. Is there a reason for that?
The reason is that there is the cross-linking of the molecules of the gel, of the gelma, that create the network that support, and because it starts from a liquid solution and become solid at the end. So there is a cross-linking that increases the storage modulus.
In the absence of light?
No. In the absence of light, if you see the different levels, it's related to the concentration and to the degree of matriculation of the of the material. Then you, when you start, we illuminate with
the... only with light, because I thought post-curing means in the absence of light, but...
No, it's just during the light.
Okay, thanks for the clarification. Yes, there seems to be a question.
Thank you for the presentation. How did you choose gelma for your studies? Does it have to, has something to do with sort of, since you are aiming for the toxicity application, or how did you choose?
About phototoxicity, there is no phototoxicity in particular, because we tested and there is no specific phototoxicity, because also the light irradiation is very fast at the end, so there is no time to kill cells in some way. The gelma solution was choose because for the flexibility in the modulation of the stiffness, and so it's possible to modulate different modulating the concentration, modulating the right radiation, you can change completely all the mechanical parameters, obtaining more stiff tissue or more soft tissue. So it's quite flexible in this use.
Okay. Thanks.
Welcome.
Any other questions?
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you for the nice talk. I just have two quick questions. The first is, maybe I missed it, like your cardiomyocytes, you differentiate, are they more atrial or ventricular phenotype?
We didn't characterize in this way.
Mm-hmm.
Probably are much more ventricular than the atrial, for sure.
Okay, thank you. And then the second question is, you stated really nice the impact of the stiffness of GMR. Did you ever look into the contractile behavior in 2D and in 3D?
We are checking this part because we are also testing the highest concentration, in particular the 10 to observe, but we are still working on the evaluation of the contraction and the differences. For sure there is some difference because in the end 2D is completely free, cells are completely free with respect to the 3D that are embedded in the gelma. So for sure there are some changes, but yeah, we are checking this aspect.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
Any last question? Okay, then I would like to thank Federico for the great talk, and also with this we come to the end of this session, so thank you everybody also for the lively discussion, and let's have a final round of applause for all our speakers. Thank you.